This house was in the newspaper for selling for $30 million. A house like this doesn't represent success. It represents hoarding wealth. It represents homelessness, suffering, oppression, and that one family gets to live in this multi-billion dollar existence while the rest of the world is suffering and dying. And they're doing it on the backs of those people.
This is Gregory Stevens, a Baptist pastor. He was forced to resign from his church after he tweeted that Palo Alto was a shit den of hate and disgusting.
So rather than creating eloquent tweets and using the language of the elite class, I kind of used some curse words.
The Palo Alto community was outraged by his tweets, and the conflict sparked a national conversation about the Silicon Valley wealth divide.
They tried to scapegoat my frustration and my anger with their larger system and their larger neighborhood by saying, I'm the problem, my language is the problem, that I'm the immoral pastor, as opposed to this sort of centralization of wealth or the homeless people living on the street. So this is Palo Alto, the line that divides Palo Alto from the lower income neighborhood, East Palo Alto. This way is $5 to $30 million houses. Larry Page, the owner of Google, lives over there. The owner of Apple, Tim Cook, lives over there. And then over here you have, I think, our only nonprofit homeless shelters, five of them, I think. You have black and brown communities. So it's kind of hard to see. Where is the explicit injustice? It's in a beautiful building like this. You wouldn't think that this is unjust or wrong, but in reality it is. It's because it's destroying a neighborhood that's traditionally black and brown without having any communication or participation with those communities. So we're at Facebook, the headquarters of so much of social media in Silicon Valley. It's at the very edge of East Palo Alto. This is the cheaper land. This is the part of town that traditionally people who were oppressed and marginalized were kicked out to. This is the type of place that if you get kicked out of your job working at Facebook in the kitchen, that you're gonna have to come to, because there's nowhere else that you can go. There's not another job that you can get in this town. And so it means you end up in a homeless shelter. You can't publicly exist as a poor person in Palo Alto, and so it's illegal if you sleep in your car. It's illegal, or they're trying to make it illegal for you to sleep in your RV. If you can walk around Palo Alto and see architecture where all the benches have an armband right in the middle so that you couldn't lie there. We're about to see Jeff Bezos become a trillionaire. I mean, the wealth gap is becoming so extreme. This is a perfect example of how extreme it can be. And so my problem with Palo Alto is they wanted me to feed the poor, but I wanted to ask, why are there poor people? If this is a multi-million billion dollar neighborhood, why are there people living on the streets?